Hi guys, welcome to today's class. We're going to be taking lesson 2 of algebra. Last week we looked at introduction to algebra, right? We're just going to refresh our memory on what we did last week. We looked at what algebra is and addition and subtraction of algebras with algebras, okay? Today we're going to be looking at the two other operations relating with algebra, that is multiplying and dividing with algebra. Okay, so let's go into the business of today. Multiplication with algebra. First, we are going to be looking at the simple part, then before we move to the complex part. Is that okay? Okay, so let's look at this. An example, we have multiply a by a. Remember when we are doing addition, if I were to have a plus a, what will it give me? 2a. Very good. I believe we still remember that. Okay, but when we are doing multiplication, is quite different. A times a is going to give us a squared, or a raised to the power of 2. So when we have a times a times a, it will give us a raised to the power of 3. Do you get that? Good. Let's check another example out. We have multiply 3a squared by a b. First of all, we are going to expand these numbers with its letter, okay, so that we know what it is actually, what is made up of, and then we are going to bring it back again together. 3a raised to the power of 2, or 3a squared, is same as 3 times a times a, while ab is same as a times b. So when you see this expression ab, it means you are multiplying a by b. Is that okay? Good. So now, looking at what we have here, we have 3 and we have a in 3 places. That's a raised to the power of 3 and then b. So when we multiply all these together, we have 3a raised to the power of 3b. Good. Now let's check example 3. We have 3a times 2b. Here we have number with the letter at both ends. So we are going to expand it first. So 3a is same as what? 3 times a. Thank you for following me. And now 2b is same as 2 times b. So just like we looked at addition when we are doing it last week, we bring like terms together, right? We are still going to apply that here too. Now we have 3 and 2, they are numbers, right? So we take this as like terms because they are numbers, and a and b, we take them together as like terms because they are what? Letters. Good. So here we have 3 times 2 we give us 6, and a times b we give us a b. So when we multiply all this together, the product we get is 6ab. Now let's go into the complex part of this, multiplying with brackets. Remember when we are doing the addition, we said the first root take off the bracket. We don't do that here. This is quite different, but we are still going to take out the bracket, but not as easy as it were last week. It's just addition. It wasn't really, the bond was not closed, but now the bond is closed. There's a number attached to a bracket with no sign. When you see things like this, it means that there's a multiplication operation going on. So we have to follow this golden rule. Use any number attached to a bracket to multiply all the numbers individually to take off the bracket. Do we understand that? What it means is that we are going to use 2 to multiply what we have inside the brackets individually. Okay, look deep close into the brackets. We have 3 plus 2 guests, right? If we were to have 3 guests plus 2 guests, easily we just add up together because they are like terms. But now they are not like terms, so we are going to do this work separately. So I have 2 times 3. I'm going to remove my bracket now by multiplying 2 times 3, which will give me 6. And then I'm still going to use the same 2 to multiply 2 girls. Remember our plus sign, we drop it. Now 2 times 2 girls will give us 4 girls. So when I have 2 brackets, 3 plus 2 girls, I'm going to have 6 plus 4 girls. What this question means, they are asking us twice of 3 plus 2 girls will give us 6 plus 4 girls. Very good. Now we are going to be looking at dividing with algebra. Simple. Here we have our first example, divide n by n. We are just going to represent this in fraction form, which is m over n. M as our numerator and n as our denominator. That's just it. So if we have 2m divided by 3n, our answer will be 2m over 3n. As simple as that. Okay, so now let's look at simplification. Now, example 2, we are asked to simplify this expression. Okay, remember, simplifying means reduced to its lowest term. Good. So I have 3m raised to the power of 4n over 6n. Look closely at the number. You can see there is an attachment, right? It means we are still going to be doing multiplication here also. So first we are going to what? Expand it. Then before simplifying it to its lowest term. So 3m raised to the power of 4n is same as 3 times m times m times m times m times n. Who followed me to do that? Good. Now we have 6n, which is same as 6 times n. Don't worry about this 2 here. I'm going to explain how we get that. Okay, so now we want to simplify. So we look for what we can reduce. We have 3 at the numerator and 6 at the denominator. We can reduce this, right? By its common factor, which is 3. We can reduce 3 by 3 and 6 by 3, right? We have to do same thing both to the numerator and denominator by dividing the numbers by 3. So here we have 3 divided by 3 give us 1 and 6 divided by 3 give us 2. So that's how we get the 2 here. Okay, so now looking at our numerator, we have n, but our denominator, no sight of n, so we're just going to leave it. Now look at our numerator again, we have n, our denominator n, so I can reduce this, I can cancel this by this. So what will I be having left? I have left m times m times m times m over 2, which will give us n raised to the power of 4 over 2. Wow, that was interesting. Okay, for this week, we are going to be playing a mathematical game. Who is excited about that? So I want you to hurry up, go to your assignments page on your school portal, and the instructions are there to guide you on how to get the game. Now, I'm going to be checking the winner of our mathematical game. Till next week, I am going to see you, and I hope you stay safe and read your books. Okay, stay blessed and be good.